Hi there. In this demonstration, I'm going to show you how to do a simple bar graph in Excel. It's one of the fastest, easiest things to do in Excel. And I'm going to do it from scratch. That's how easy it is. So I'm going to make a bar graph of types of trees versus their average height. All right, so column one, I'm going to put the data in first. This will be tree type. And notice I'm not formatting these cells or anything. Excel will pick up on what the formatting is based on what I put in there. For example, the first thing I want to put in here is a quaking aspen. That is a type of tree. That is a qualitative data type. And then balsam poplar, maybe. Good. And then a cottonwood, a yellow birch, and then a red maple. So those are the tree types. And then over in the second column, I'm going to put in some numeric. This will be the height of the bars. So this will be height, or average height. So the quaking aspen, that's about 55 feet. Balsam poplar is around 70. Cottonwood is around 80. Yellow birch is 65. And red maple is, say, 82. I'm not exactly sure how accurate these are. They're close, but I just grabbed them off the internet. So please don't hold me accountable for the actual average height of the quaking aspen. Okay, so once we have our table, getting the graph is super easy. I'm going to highlight both columns. All right, and you can actually highlight the labels too, but I didn't. Insert. Look, there's a picture of a bar graph right up here. That's what we want. We're just going to do a single bar graph, one bar for each category. And so it's the top left, very first one. And there you have it. All right. We've got our bar graph. Those are the various heights corresponding to these numbers in the table. So I also like to format my table so that it has some labels like a title, axis labels, things like that. So if I go over here, once I click on the actual graph, I get these chart tools. See the chart tools in green pops up right up here. When I'm not on the graph, you don't see that. So you click on the graph, those appear. You have design, layout, format. I'm going to go to design. On the far left, I have chart layouts. I like to have one that has some labels. Like if you look, this one has a title. This one has a title and an x-axis. I also like to have the y-axis. So I'm going to go down to here, layout 9. But like you can play around with all of these. You're not committed to any one, right? And then notice, so that's the one I like because it has axis labels and a title. And notice, sometimes Excel will put the diagonal X variable to save space. Sometimes it doesn't. I'm not sure exactly the algorithm that makes that decision. But it usually looks pretty good, and the background software does a fine job with it. There's only one series, so I don't need this thing on the right. So I get rid of that. And look, it switches it back to two rows instead of the diagonal. The x-axis, those are tree types, but that's pretty obvious from the actual actual variable. So I'm going to get rid of that one. But here, the y-axis, I am going to change that label to, average height. All right, so that's my y-axis, and then my chart title will be tree heights, right? And there you go, and there's all sorts of things. You can play around with color and things like that if you want. And whenever you go to layout and format, you can really play around with this thing to make it look good. But it comes out looking pretty good. Pretty quickly. It's well done. You know, a lot of people don't like Excel for various statistical purposes, but for making simple graphs, charts, things like this, it's really fast, it's really easy, and it's user-friendly. Oh, and there's one other thing you can do. Suppose, nice thing about these is that it's immediately interactive with this table. Notice when I click this graph, it highlights this table, so it's actually getting the data, the bar graph heights from this data. So if I change, say, my balsam poplar to a yellow poplar, which is bigger, it changes the title down here, the label, that variable is now yellow poplar. But now I change the average height to, say, 110 feet, and it changes that bar. So it changes and it rescales the entire graph. So it's very interactive. You can update it as you go along. It's really nice. It's fast, it's convenient, and it's especially convenient because a lot of times you just get your data in an Excel file anyway, and you can take a quick look at it with the use of a bar graph. And that wraps it up for us. Excel, bar graphs, easy. Bye.